In this one, we'll have a look at the performance of Borderlands 4 across popular GeForce RTX graphics cards, including the 30 series, 40 series, and the 50 series. We'll be testing a 1080p, 1440p, and 4K at native, as well as with upscaling and frame generation enabled. At native 1080p BIOS settings, actual 1080p cards like the RTX 4060, 4060 Ti, and the 5060 barely manage playable frame rates. They're stuck under 30 FPS. For playable frame rates at 1080p native BIOS, we'll need a higher end card like the 4070 Super, 4070 Ti, or the 5070 Ti. Even then, there'll be drops to the lower 40s, so upscaling is kind of a given in this game. Here we have the RTX 3080 Ti, the 4060, the 4070 Super, and the 4070 Ti running in 1080p BIOS settings with balanced upscaling. DLSS balanced upscaling. So as you can see, the 4060 is barely above 30 FPS, and that is with balanced upscaling enabled. The 3080 Ti hovers around 60, the 4070 Super stays around the 70 FPS mark, while the 4070 Ti averages around 80. Despite delivering rather consistent 60 FPS, you can see that the frame time graph 3080 Ti is sort of shaky, a lot of spikes, a lot of inconsistent frame times there. At 1080p BIOS, all the mode upscaling, the 4070 Ti averages 77 FPS, 4070 Super manages 73 FPS, the 3080 Ti manages 62 FPS, and the 4060 just hits 30. Interestingly, the 3080 Ti performs rather poorly when it comes to the frame times and the 1% levels. It dips down to 39 FPS, which is really kind of ruins the gameplay. Ranging above 45 FPS, then frame gen can be an easy way of boosting your frame rate. But if you're lower than that, then it can lead to choppiness, input lag, and all other kinds of stutters. So here we have 1080p balanced, BIOS settings, balanced upscaling, and frame gen. The 3080 Ti manages around 110 FPS, the 4060 averages around 50 to 60 FPS, the 4070 Super hovers around 120 to 130 FPS, and the 4070 Ti averages 140. Now, most of the cards are stable except the 4060 because the input frame times are too low. We're under 40 FPS without frame gen. So enabling frame gen improves the frame rates, but the frame times are still kind of inconsistent, and it leads to quite a bit of input lag. If you're looking at the overall average frame rates at 1080p balanced BIOS settings with frame gen, the 4070 Ti averages 145 FPS for those of 109. The 4070 Super averages 126, 127 with those of 75 FPS. The 3080 Ti averages 120, with rather stable lows here, 90 FPS. But this is FSR frame gen, not DLSS. 4060 averages 59 with lows of 44. Again, this looks playable here, but like it's not stable. There's too much input lag, there's too much stuttering in between, as it's indicated by the 43, 44 FPS lows. Badass native DLA. Only the 4090 manages to hit 60 FPS. The 5070 Ti is stuck at around 42, 43. 4070 Ti averages 38. The 4070 Super hits around 35. And the 3080 Ti is pretty much smack dab at 30 FPS with horrible lows of around 20 FPS. Upscaling makes things more playable. The 3080 Ti is now averaging 50 FPS, still poor lows of 34, 35. The 4070 Super does manage to hit 60 FPS, but once again, the lows are just too low, 43. The 4070 Ti averages 66 with lows of 57. This is quite playable. And the 5070 Ti manages around 68 FPS, lows of 53. Once again, not ideal, but playable. 4090 averages 84 at 60 FPS lows. This is what ideal would look like. Here you can see the cards in action, the 3080 Ti on the left, 4070 Super, the 4070 Ti, and the 5070 Ti. Like before, the 3080 Ti is quite stuttery, a lot of frame time spikes. Not a very consistent experience. I reckon this is because of the absence of the large L2 cache, which all the newer cards have. So because of that, UE5 tends to use a lot of last level cache on the GPU, which is probably why the 3080 Ti is struggling. And the 4070 Super, 4070 Ti, and the 5070 Ti all are playable to quite enjoyable. But the 4070 Super is a bit stuttery. You need to reduce a few settings. But the 4070 Ti and the 5070 Ti are running well. The frame time graphs of these cards at 1440p balanced, upscaled, show what's happening. The frame times of the 3080 Ti are quite unstable. Lots of spikes, lots of stutters. I would not call that playable. Oh, it is playable, but not ideal. The 4070 Super also has quite a bit of spikes. Not completely stable gameplay. And then the 4070 Ti is quite relatively stable, not many spikes. And the 5070 Ti performs the best with minimal stuttering. If you have a relatively high-end or upper mid-range GPU, then Frame Gen works really well with balanced upscaling at 1440p badass. 4070 Super averages 105, the 4070 Ti does 109, the 5070 Ti averages 120, and the 4090 averages almost 150 FPS. The 3080 Ti also does well with Frame Gen. The stuttering, most of the stuttering is kind of gone. The one you see with balanced and native. See, the Frame Gen seems to offset the missing effect of the impact of the missing cache. Here you have the 3080 Ti on the left, 4070 Super, 4070 Ti, and the 5070 Ti. Most of them stay above 100, except the 3080 Ti with dips below 100, 280, 290. They're all still very much playable, very consistent. There are stutters every now and then associated with you know, Unreal 5 issues, traversal-related stutter, compile shader, compilation-related shutter. But overall, it's pretty stable. 4K native badass settings, the 4090 averages just 34 FPS. The 5070 Ti struggles with around 84 FPS, but drops into the late teens. This is hardly as far from playable. So, yeah, with balanced upscaling enabled, the 4090 managed to hit 60 FPS, but there's still more than a few drops. I wouldn't call this ideal. You need to drop a few settings to high. The 5070 Ti averages 45 with lows of 38. Again, kind of stuttery and not playable. 4070 Ti does around 40 FPS with drops to 30 and even under 30 at times. The 4070 Super averages 37 with drops to under 30 FPS at times. Here you can see the four cards in action, the 4070 Super, the 4070 Ti, the 5070 Ti, and the 4090. Only the 4090 manages to, you know, stay anywhere close to 60. The rest of the GPUs are stuck in the 30s or the 40s. One notable tidbit, the 4070 Ti stutters quite a bit more than the 5070 Ti, despite having not that much lower average frame rate. I reckon this is because of the bandwidth, the extra bandwidth that comes with the GDDR7 memory on the 5070 Ti. At balanced upscaled 4K, the 5070 Ti maintains a much more consistent frame time graph. It's very similar to the 4090, but the 4070 Ti as well as the 4070 Super, they're both V cards. I'm not sure if it's because of the memory buffer or the slower memory, which reduces the overall bandwidth. Older 12GB RTX 40 series cards struggle quite a bit at 4K, about even if the average frame rate seemed stable. Higher end 40 series cards like the 4080 and the 4090, as well as the 5070 Ti and other 50 series cards with 60GB VRAM, can brute force their way at 4K badass with Frame Gen. And the 4090 averages 103 FPS with lows of 77. The 5070 Ti averages 79 with lows of 62. The lower end 40 series cards like the 4070 Ti, the 4070 Super, and I also reckon the 5070 kind of struggle here because of their smaller VRAM buffers. It is technically playable, but the input lag can be quite distracting. Here you can see the 3080 Ti, the 4070 Super, the 4070 Ti, the 5070 Ti, and the 4090 running at 4K badass with balanced upscaling and frame gen. The 5070 Ti and the 4090 stay well over 60 FPS at all times, but the 4070 Ti, the 4070 Super drop to 60 or lower, which can greatly impact frame times and the overall experience. If you have an 8GB GPU, then you need to reduce this extra quality too high and use upscaling, preferably balanced upscaling. If you're using Frame Gen and experience stutters, that means it's probably a VRAM limitation, so you'll have to scale down to medium quality textures with Frame Gen at 1080p. 1440p uses around 12GB at badass native, so 12GB cards shouldn't have any issue running maxing out texture settings, particularly if you're using upscaling. 4K uses around 15GB, so 16GB cards should be good at 4K.